So I'll be sharing you one plist file. Again, plist is very straightforward. So I'll be sharing you the folder. So this is a very old file to demonstrate plist. It's very simple. We know what is mutable dictionary and dictionary. Key value pair. There's one function in mutable dictionary called dot write. So when you say dot write, you have to give a file path. Now file path will be which directory? Document directory. You cannot write anywhere else apart from document directory. So document directory where you will create a path slash file name dot plist. Extension is plist. Key value pair is plist. And that the mutable dictionary has a function called dot write. That's it. So whatever dictionary you have, that will go. Now suppose you want to write the entire object like a person, which won't go directly. Because person object is not universally accepted. It's your own project, right? It's there you need a serialization. So there you have to write coder, inhibit coder. रिमेंबर राइट तो उसका एक स्टेप होता है कोडर में एनकोड डीकोड करके फंक्शन आएगा एनकोड में यू राइट इन अ सीक्वेंस डीकोड में यू राइट अ राइट सीक्वेंस ओके एंड दैट्स इट देन यू कैन राइट टू योर प्रेफरेंसेस एज इट वोंट अलाउ यू टू राइट इन टू द प्रेफरेंसेस क्लियर एवरीवन रेस्ट ऑल द अदर ऑब्जेक्ट्स स्ट्रिंग इंटीजर फ्लोट डेट डेटा इज अलाउड डायरेक्टली बिकॉज दे आर ऑलरेडी आर्काइवेबल User-defined objects are not archivable because they are not serialized by default. That same thing in other languages also, right? Okay. So I'll just share you this plist file. It's a very small single controller file. Unzip it into your given folder. So unzip, you will get one controller file. Here you have to use NS Mutable Dictionary. Remember, NS Mutable Dictionary I used two times. One was with the web service when you want to send the data to the server, and second is here. Okay. Even done. Just put them in your given folder. I have to call for the map. Shall I? So I'll go to session progress, create a new folder, 18 dot Release demo. Copy paste of code data project. Now .plist is a file extension in Mac. Huh? So if you write 18.plist, it will say that the file is created. Right? Plist demo. Like .storyboard is also an extension. So I go to project 2. I'll add that folder. That folder already contains a controller file. Okay. Make sure you select the copy and all. Add that folder and add that controller to your delegate. Less than 10. Done. Shall we start reviewing this code? Now it's a very simple code. Chalo dekhte hain kaise solve karenge. Suppose you got some code. Now see here. Now this is, see, the major issue is this code was written way back before. Now all this NS are replaced, right? The issues are already with NS. So you click on this. It's a fix. वो search directory को file manager से search directory करेगा. वापस error आएगा. वापस वो fix बोलेगा. Okay? It's a good exercise when you get some legacy code integrated in a new framework. So you don't have to worry. Just call fix. Automatically everything will get fixed. Everyone, or kidhar hai issues? Print ln ko replace karo print se. Pehle print ln hua karta tha. कोई टेंशन नहीं है, फिक्स करते रहो, अपना हो जाएगा. ओके, फाइल मैनेजर डॉट डिफॉल्ट मैनेजर. लो मेरे सारे फिक्स हो गए. Yeah, things to be done. क्या करना है ये लो, यू कैन जस्ट सी द कोड. It's see initially it was white color. I told you, right? We used to have static method, which got replaced with white. So you will get such errors when you're gonna import some code from the online, right? You can refer this code here. So now instead of white color, we have white. UI rect edge dot none used to be used. Now it's a constructor. Here, a lot of issue came, right? NS file manager, NS search document. So you all replace, you just say fix, fix, fix. Automatically it'll start.
NS file manager.
अरे यहाँ पे आपका सर्च में आ गया, बहुत दो बार आ गया. अब मुझे थोड़ा स्लो तो थोड़ा आराम से आएगा. ओके या सब में फिक्स आएगा. हो गया लो, किसका बाकी है? हरीश का. सो एवरीवन लेट्स रन थ्रू दिस कोड. सबका हो गया एरर सॉल्व फिक्स फिक्स करके. दिस टाइप ऑफ इश्यूज यू विल फेस. यू लॉट ऑफ कोड सिनेप्स आर ओल्ड सिनेप्स. When you try to integrate them in your code, you might get such errors, but it's all simple. Just say fix, 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 and keep on fixing it. Now, everyone, first two lines again are standard line for document directory. Okay, they will never change. Obviously, वो NS मैंने हटा के उन्होंने नाम change कर लिया और कुछ नहीं किया. Now I want to create a plist, so I have to create a dumb path, right? So I say document directory slash my plist 1.plist. Suppose you want to download an image, so you have to create a path, na? So you will say image 1.jpg or image 1.png, whatever. Okay. Now you have to create mutable dictionary. NS mutable dictionary. Now you will get, you need a file manager to read the hard drive. Now if file exists, you will initialize mutable dictionary with content of file. Okay, so now suppose you have server but you have plist files, you can say content of URL and URL se bhi aapka file initialize ho sakta hai. Okay, so if dictionary doesn't exist, so you create a mutable dictionary. Now see here, as I told you, right, int वो सब नहीं चलेगा NS mutable में. NS number चलेगा. It's an NS mutable dictionary. It's an Objective C. Okay. So I've created one number with value 1, and then I show set object for key 1. Okay. Everyone. Then I want to write to the hard drive. So this is the function. Anytime you want to write a dictionary into a plist, write to the path, feel his path atomically, not automatically. 100% or 0%. Now you'll say, I want to update. So you get your plish first into your NS mutable dictionary, add, subtract, jo bhi karna karo, and then again say write. It will override the existing one. Okay. Now, this is the way I've shown you, right? Key value pair normally, dictionary, how you print. Okay. Now I'm checking for value key 2. Obviously, for the first none, value V2 will be 0, right? Nil. But there's nothing called V2, right? Key to where. So I'll set the value default. I'm just taking some temp sample. So, and then again, I'm writing it. So two values will go, right? Key one and key two. Clear, everyone? So when I run for the first time, I'll get this NS log. Then I'll get this NS log. Then I'll get this NS log. I'll get this NS log. And this NS log, right? If I see the flow, when I run on the second time, I'll get this flow. I'll get this print. And then I'll get this print. Clear, everyone? So let's run and see. Only logs we'll have to check, huh? So clear, this is where we can have key value pair. Now suppose you want to encrypt, now there is something called encryption frameworks are there. So you can convert this plist. It's a data, right? Content of URL. You know data equal to content of file path. You get the data, you can encrypt it, and you can again send it back. So this is where you can encrypt and decrypt your key value pair directly. Easy, simple and easy way of storing the data, your key, password and all. Encrypt ho gaya, khatam ho gayi baat. Clear, everyone? So when I run this, see my plish didn't exist. It got created. Value 1, key 1. Key 2 doesn't exist. Value 1, value 2. Everyone, when I run it for a second time, it'll say exist. The database. So the dictionary exists. It's reading. Again, run for 2 times directly. Key one, key one, key one, key two. Clear, everyone, with plist? Everyone? Now, there is something called NS user defaults. This is user defined. Ye aapki document directory mein chalti hai. Okay? This is you have created your plist, right? There is one more topic before we make a move. Yahi pe aap likh lo. There is something called user default. Initially, it used to call NS user default dot standard dot set. I'll say key value key one. You can set integer, float, double, whatever you want. Okay. Now this is again a plist only, but it's a system plist. Every app will have one system plist. Now, clear, everyone? So now if I want to get this value, I'll say you can directly write integer dot float dot double dot boolean, provided when setting you are setting the right value. Agar aap setting ke time pe float dal rahe ho, yahan pe integer se kar rahe ho na, to crash karega. Everyone? So this is how we use preferences. So in this code only you can write preferences. We don't have to create a separate project for this. So it's a user defined. So plist is user defined. User default is system preference. Every app will have one user defaults. So suppose you want to store only some data like flags, which I told you, right? Setting flag of scrapes and everything. We store a user default. We don't care plist. You can store, but username path is easy.
hackers, it's difficult to hack user default. It's not that easy. But वो hackable. Everything is hackable. उसके ऊपर आता है keychain. वो भी hackable है. Then keychain is also key value. Okay? Tomorrow anyways we'll see keychain, how to use keychain in Mac. Every iOS device or Mac device has keychain. उसके ऊपर आता है plist. Plist is rather readable है तो directly. But if you encrypt and send, then it's easy. You cannot encrypt user default. But user default is not easily available. You know, we have some when you connect the iPhone and you have Mac mein, Windows mein, third party apps, right? Just explore your iPhone into a hard drive. Document directly pura visible. So whatever you have downloaded, image, video, sab dikhta hai. Usme user default aapko kabhi nahi dikhega. Yeah, so we use user default for configuration settings. Anyways, the security should be there at API level only. So we don't use any primary keys, we use signatures and all. That's only there. And here, only thing you can encrypt. Fields ko data mein convert karke usko encrypt karke wapas store kar sakte ho. Ek tarika hai. Simple and dirty. SQLite also you can encrypt, but SQLite encryption, there is a third party library called SQLite Cipher. That's the only library used across the group. And I think they never changed to Swift. They don't, it's an Objective-C library, but that's heavy. Suppose you have thousands of records, hundreds of records to be inserted, it'll take time. So normally SQLite, no one encrypts. Basically what they do, they encrypt the plist, which is very straightforward and simple. So all your critical information can have key value pairs. And other data in SQLite are your dumps only. Basically, what you want to get from web server is a subset of your data, not the entire server. And even if that gets compromised, only one user is getting on it, not the entire server. So normally, security-wise in mobile apps, there is no such headache as we have a headache on a website. Because you have multiple user data to be protected, right? Now Apple and everyone say, if you give your device and you open it from third party app, then it is the user who is responsible. Not the sandboxing is already there. So other app cannot read directly your data. Okay, so that's it. That's all we're saying is security. Encryption frameworks are available directly used. There's encrypt data, encrypted data kaya, file system mein dal do. Decrypt karke, plist kiya, sab utha lo. Hey everyone. Okay. So these are all variations we have. So if you run this, you'll get value one. You comment the for the stat. So now when I run again, I have three lines already written, right? Then I go here. I got value one, right? Everyone. Now what I'll do? I'll comment this line. I'll check, right? Again, I'm getting value one or not. You will get. So all your user profile login ke details hoti hai na, email ID hai, phone number hai, which is like a public very things only, but not confidential, right? We put in preferences only. Okay, we don't create plist and all. But if you want to have put some password and all, create plist, encrypt and send it. So once it's encrypted, then you don't have to worry. It won't be visible. Okay, and Android and iOS both has the crypto 236, whatever, 24, whatever, everything is available. SQLite cipher is very risky, huh? It's very slow, it's encryption too slow, but that's the only ideal way. It's a free library, you can use it, but that's the only way where you can do encryption of SQLite. There's no direct way. Some people say, what if we encrypt the value and then put, that's also fine. But then you have to take a call. Performance versus security. And always remember, it's per person data, that's also a subset of the data. So if you enhance your API calls properly, that data will not have any impact on your existing user and other users also. So now we store only data which are like newsfeed. Not confident. Transactional data anyways you should not put.
That's not allowed. Okay. Rest everything you can stay when. So you have to take a call. Clear, everyone? So this is all we have for the story. So till today, yesterday and today's session covers your 80% of use cases. Web services and database. And all this is in a monotonous only. Your only structures will be different. Flow will be still the same. Tomorrow we'll start with the memory management first thing, early morning. Push notification architecture I'll show you. It will run directly without any issue. Okay. I will check with my server whether I have those test credentials available or not. Deployment is again an important thing which you will learn tomorrow. And then fonts, how to use fonts instead of images. Okay. Then you have animations and unit tests. How to write unit test cases, TDDs. Okay. And then if time permits, we'll, and time will be there. So I have already asked for my developer to give me a Mac car POC. So whatever he have done, I'll just show it to you. Okay. And anything else you want to understand, we'll discuss. We'll have an open session. Okay. So I'll show you white labels, how to create multiple targets, database scripts, to update database scripts on a go. And these are two things. That's it. Rest everything is then doable. Okay. So tomorrow we will have less of coding and more of a this type of work. It's like a frameworking. That's it. Okay.
So, for a use case like kind of a Facebook kind of thing, right? So you connect to the server with the API and you fetch the data and show it up on the screen. So is that a good use case, or getting the data, storing in the database and then showing it?
That second one.
Second one,
anytime. Because if you see, it gives you a better user experience. So when network is not, still your feeds are shown to the user. And
so,
then
I was asking, like, showing to the user, and in the background you do that saving part, or should I save it and
quit? No, save it and do it, because your news feed won't come 10 news feeds together. As for the page ingestion, you will get only 5 news feeds, because your JSON data will not be huge. So storing and showing it won't take anything. It won't take even milliseconds. It will be too fast. So why you want to do a headache? You create an architecture that way that parser runs in background, parser collects the data, dumps that data into your database directly in the background. Okay. And gives you an indication that I'm done. Then at a control level, you call the database, get the data. So at control level, you always check data available and dikha dunga bas. So in Facebook, that only happened. In on create or whatever, view did load or view will appear. They check database, data 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 starting main, and then they initiate silently one parser. So when parser comes, so it might delete the data because it's a new newsfeed, right? So you see, sometimes your newsfeed gets disappeared automatically. If you want to try that, you try it on 2G ka spectrum. You will clearly see that your data comes, and after some time, your newsfeed goes off. And a new data comes in. With the fast internet, you won't be able to realize. It's called silently showing the data. Secondly, we have a lot of framework we have created for search and all those in pagination directly. So over the years, we have just created a framework directly. So we just have flags on search, whether you want to delete the data from database or not. So during the search only, we do all those things. So it's always the second case. The optimization happens only in second case. If it's a huge app, 100 screen app, how are you going to manage? So you have to store the data in database, clean up your RAM, and when again you come on that screen, you ask database to get the data. You won't connect to the server. A lot of masters we put in database directly. One time, first time loaded and goes in database.
So storing data, core data will be.
No. The longer, then that is again the same. If you're knowing that there is no update going to happen in your structure, then core data is fine.
Data structure is not changing, core data.
It is fine. Okay. And secondly, you're dumping huge data. Enterprise app core data using Google 5 years old. Well, Apple and everyone says use core data. I have to see it in my 10 years. Core data is a horrible thing. The day when you get an update, this guy has also got an issue, right? एक कॉलम चेंज करने में लोग का उसमें फट गई तो आप यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड अरे रन टाइम सम अपडेट हैपेंस इट्स अ नाइटमेयर फॉर श्योर पीपल लिटरली राइट स्क्रिप्ट्स टू डंप दैट डेटा इनटू अ न्यू डेटा सो व्हाट हैपेंस बेसिकली लॉट ऑफ टाइम आई सीन स्टुपिडिटी दे क्रिएट अ न्यू कोर डेटा फाइल इन अ न्यू लॉन्च दैट मींस यू हैव टू कोर डेटा फाइल यू कैन नॉट डिलीट अ प्रीवियस वाला एंड यू हैव अ न्यू वन सो इंक्रीज योर ऐप साइज एंड देन ऑन अ लॉन्च यू राइट अ स्क्रिप्ट दिस वर्जन से ये कोर डेटा से So launch time also it happens a launch time goes good amount of time. Then you have multiple updates. Whereas in SQLite you can write directly scripts. The way you have in your server side, right? You update, you write those alter and all create table scripts. That you can do easily. Then I'll show you it tomorrow. Tomorrow I'll show you most of the framework what we use. Okay, I won't be able to share, but I will be able to tell you this is the way you should do it. I can share you the code synapse. I cannot share you the entire thing because it's under the proprietary license of our company. I can share you. I can show you the algorithm there. Okay.
When you're updating the app, what portions are actually getting updated? Like documents, I guess it's not removed. It's retained, I guess, right?
Everything is retained.
Everything is retained. What's actually replaced?
Your object files, classes are always replaced. Your new resources are added. That's it. Nothing more. Existing one will not be added. So you don't update your SQLite file. It'll definitely gonna crash. Your existing user have an old SQLite file. Your new code has a new table. Saying that no, I have a new table. They will never get that table. क्योंकि आपका कोड क्या लिखता है डॉक्यूमेंट डायरेक्टरी में फाइल है तो कॉपी थोड़ी करना है उससे आपके पास तो हमेशा पुराना फाइल ही दिखेगा सो वी राइट स्क्रिप्ट्स इन दैट केस वी हैव अपडेट वंस द फाइल इज लॉन्च डेटाबेस फाइल वंस गोज लाइव इट्स अ रूल नेवर अपडेट अ फाइल देन यू डू प्रोग्रामेटिकली दैट्स द ओनली वे एदर कोड डेटा जो भी है दैट टुमारो आई विल डिस्कस इन डिटेल So tomorrow we'll spend more time on that type of work. Actual. So I am purely from an enterprise apps background nowadays. I don't make small apps. So we don't take project below 2 years, 3 years timeline. Pointless. So I can help you in that. I'll show you the apps which we work. Okay. Obviously I won't be able to share the code. That's for sure. But obviously you can see the flow and everything. Along. Algorithm you can note it down. And then you make it easy. Okay? But everything is based on memory optimization. If you focus on memory optimization, all these things are free of it. Offline management is free of cost. Everything is free of cost. Okay? Yeah? So we'll stop here today. Tomorrow, get as many questions as possible. Okay?